So hello, today I'm going to talk about the integrated library, how you can create the integrated library using a library package, and how you can add your schematic library and PCB library into this integrated library package. So as you can see that I have already opened here my Altium Designer 21, and what you have to do, you have to go to the file. In the file, you have to choose new. And in new, when you will go, then go to the library, and in library you have to choose this integrated library. Once you choose this integrated library, so here as you can see that it has already created a library package which is called integrated library 1. Library package. There are two ways to add source schematic library, and the first one is that either you can go again to the file new in library and choose here schematic library. So schematic library, as you can see that, so it has added this. Let me save this as a project group. Let's say it integrated SMD design workspace 01. Save this, and let's call it schematic SMD. Save it. That's how you can add the, let me save all this. So that's how you can add. That is the one way. Or the second way is that you can right click, add new to project, and then here choose schematic library. So yeah, these are the two ways. And for the PCB integrated library, where you have your 2D and 3D models, so how you can add your domain model files. For example, for PCB 2D and 3D, there are again three ways. The first way is like the schematic library. For that, what you can do, you can again go to the file new, and then from here select, go to the library and then select PCB library. And second way is, let me do here second way, that is you can right click here and add new to the project, and then choose here PCB library. So once you have chosen the PCB library, so when I will go to the project, so here you can see that it has already added the PCB library, where you can create your 2D model of your library component. So let me save this first. So it will ask you for PCB library where it has to save, so you have to give it to the path. Let me save it in the same, at the same place where I saved my schematic library, and which was here in integrated library. So it's here, so I saved it. So as you can see that I already added my schematic and PCB library. And the third one is, you can define a search path to the library model. So there are advantages to each method, so choose the method that best suits your work practices. So different model also work better with different approaches too. For example, you may not want to see a large number of simulation models listed in the project panel when the library project is open, but you might like to see the PCB, like 2D or 3D component model libraries. In this case, define a search path to the folder where the simulation models are stored and add the PCB library to the library package. So how you can do that? Go to your panel, and then in panel you have to open this, your component, then you have to choose here, click on this so here, and then you have to choose here file based libraries preferences, click on that, and then it will open such kind of window. When you click on this path, then you are not getting any kind of path here, I mean in the new window. When it's opening, then that there is no option for your path. Why? Because you have to do one advanced setting in your system, and that you can do So let me close this first, and that you can do, you have to click here in system preferences. You have to open this, and then you have to go to the general. When you go to the general, then in general you have to go to the advanced. Click on the advanced, and here in advanced you have to find out UI project options search path. So here, as you can see, that you have to enable this. You have to click here and here, and you must be very careful, because as you can see, that changing these settings may result in the application becoming unstable. Continue only if you know that know what you are doing. So be careful here, just don't click anywhere, otherwise you have a problem with your Altium Designer. So you have to just click here and say close, okay, and then again you have to close your Altium one time and then restart it. So I have restarted the Altium Designer, and then I copied from my my previous library this component, one of the registers, just to show you how does it works. And then again I will go back to the search path, and let's see whether search path is available in the project option or not. So here path, and here you can see that search path option is now also available. So here what you have to do, you have to go to the add, and then you have to provide here the path where your simulation file or other files are stored. So in my case, it's here, integrated library. So when I have added this path for this PCB library, as you can see that, so it's available here. So now you can close this, and in this case, even though if you will not add this, let me remove this PCB SMD library from this, exclude from the project, and you can close this, as you can see that here. And when I'm compiling here, then I'm expecting that, as I have already added this model here in my schematic library, so I'm expecting that it should be able to find out the this model through this path. So let me compile this, and after compilation, so here as you can see that, so there is no error, it has compiled correctly. So that's how also you can provide the path, and the advantage of this is that you don't need to add all your source libraries, like PCB library and simulation libraries here. So when you will open this integrated library anywhere, and so if you have here like a lot of components, so you can just choose those components, and you don't need to care for the PCB library or simulation library. They are automatically, I mean, they are already integrated here with this. So it's quite easy to look for all those things. Yeah, that's how you can create the integrated library package. And one more thing here, I mean, in the library, PCB library, I will tell you how you can activate the parameter which I defined here. For example, if I will go here, so here you can see that I have already defined this parameter here, but still here we cannot see anything. So what you have to do, you have to go to the tools and then document options. Here you can see that this document option will open, and then here what you have to do here, you have to click here, show command designator. So once you will click here, so it will show you the designator, or it will also show you the pin number, but this one we don't need. So that is more than enough. Yeah. So that's how you can activate. I hope this video is useful for you. If you like my content, then please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.